you're the guy that rolls your sleeve up to your bicep, much. That's kind of like, come on. You're not. We're not 13.
Yeah, that's not even fashionable.
More
lunch break.
Woo! Yeah. Welcome back to another episode of Lunch Break. Want to give a big shout out to our plus one, Andrew Chan, who requested Hawaiian food. I got some Hawaiian food. It's a aloha bowl.
I got some poke.
I got some katsu and mac salad.
And we also have a special guest on today's episode, June Lee.
Yay. Hello. Hi,
close
thanks
friend.
For having me.
Of course. Thank you. First time on Lunch Break.
I've always wanted to be on it. I'm not going to lie.
Oh, cool.
But you know, I stay patient. Okay. I stay
still
patient.
Honored.
You might know June. He's the creator of Ajunma, the character on IG. You might have watched his Quarantine and Chill series where he gets deep and gives a lot of love advice, too. So we thought it'd be a very appropriate guest to talk about turn-ons when it comes to like dating and relationships.
I just talked about this on my last stream, actually. I used to do it on IG Live, but now I poured it over to Twitch. So yeah, I do Quarantine and Chill on Twitch now, but last week's episode, we got into that. This is
perfect.
Fresh on my mind. This is great.
Well, let's first start off by like defining turn-ons for people that don't know. What are turn-ons, Jen?
Not a turn-off. basically something that attracts you to someone through an action they do or something they say. So you get like an immediate reaction like, ooh, I felt something.
Is that how you respond? Ooh. Is that how you respond with all
sometimes.
Your girlfriends?
Sometimes.
every K-drama moment where it goes slow-mo, they're getting turned on.
Yeah, it just...
You know, the doki-doki.
The world stops.
There's definitely a wide range of what falls under turn-ons, but,
mm-hmm.
you know, there's a lot of small things, too. Little small things that people do when you first meet someone that might, like, trigger you to be like, oh, that was hot. I have one. I'll just set us off.
Ooh.
Oh, okay.
I'm really curious.
Oh, we're starting. Okay, go.
This is kind of a... childish one. I don't know. I think I was affected by media, but when a girl used to like blow her bangs out of her face, you know what I'm talking about?
What?
Little Mermaid. You know, she like.
Oh, I know that exactly.
Or like.
Why?
I don't know. It just the way that it like went out, blew it away, and it felt like kind of quirky.
That does it for you, huh?
I was like, whoa.
That tends to be like in frustration, though, right? They're like.
Yeah.
Blow it out.
Yeah. I don't know if it's out of their they're frustrated at their hair or they're frustrated at some situation. Anyone else? Not no one else really? That's just me?
Well, I can relate
I mean,
to it.
I get it. Definitely. I get it.
Yeah.
It's not necessarily my thing.
Yeah. Okay.
Always.
Yeah.
But it could be. It could be. Who knows?
I feel like it's a basic one. Like every girl says this. It's rolling up the sleeves and show it's the arms, you know.
Is it the forearms?
The forearms, yeah.
Is it the vascularity?
It's the vascularity, right? It's the
ooh,
veins.
Yeah. Right? It's kind of like that thing where it's like, where a guy, yeah, like a guy doesn't look too buff, and you're like, I'm not sure. And then he rolls up his sleeves, and you're like, oh!
Does it matter how long it goes? Or like here, is it good? Or
yeah,
is it
optimal?
Here?
Well, optimal sleeve roll is like right... Either
here,
right before the elbow.
The elbow, but like a little bit past it.
Yeah. If you're the guy that rolls your sleeve up to your bicep, that's kind of, come on, we're not 13.
Yeah,
like,
that's not even fashionable.
You might need to put on some more weight because like you're too thin at that
point.
Yeah,
the fact that the sleeve can go past
the fact that it
the
can
bicep.
Go up that, the fact that it can even go up that far.
It's not a
so specifically, it has to be a button up. Button down? No,
that's
a difference. Okay. Yeah, it can't be a baseball tee.
I think there's something about like just formal wear in general too. Where you're just like, damn.
Oh, you're like, you're a classy girl. You like the GQs.
Yeah, like it just elevates the look.
The glow
subjective,
up.
I think. Compare because everyone has like different styles, right?
Whatever your style is, but if he
exemplified.
Is dressed in the way that is,
right.
if he's dressed
right.
in the way that you like, then like a woman's gaze, that's my weakness. I can't like you know the saying like the eyes don't lie. And I think that's true, you know? For example, if it's someone like you're dating, right? And like she looks at you like a certain way. And
oh,
it's just
yeah.
Without saying a word. And then...
Is it the Nala eyes?
The Nala eyes?
Lion King.
The live action? Or are we talking just original?
Yeah, when Beyonce looks at you.
When Beyonce... I did not see the Beyonce Nala.
No,
that would have... Right? Like, let's say we're at a function, right? Let's say we're at a group setting. Or if she were to just like across the room, like just like give me like a gaze, I'm like, all right, dude, we're
leaving this event. This event's not good enough.
I just got here, but I gotta go. I'm sorry. No, I gotta go. You know? And also for me, it's like the lip bite.
Yeah, yeah. The lip bite for me too. I don't necessarily know why, because like, what does that really mean?
I don't know.
That's so funny. So see... like for a female.
Yeah, tailor that way.
No, because like for a female, like you definitely see that in movies. Like, you know, the sexy girl's always like biting her lip, right, and stuff. And like, I feel like me, like it's like I definitely have like, you like try that at home, because I think it's like it feels so.
What do you mean?
Yeah, try it at home. Like, or you just, you know, yeah, you like look at yourself. You're like, this is so awkward. Why would anyone do this on purpose? I think it's maybe like a tick kind of thing. Like, I think people do it not knowing you're doing it.
Oftentimes is when it's like kind of involuntary. So I actually do it a lot without realizing. If you pair like a long gaze
with a lip bite,
that's game over. That's game over. That's
game marriage. Over. Your wet babies are coming.
I'm gonna propose right there.
Like, my girlfriend does this gaze too, but there's times where she holds it a little too long. I'm like, okay. the moment's passed a little bit, and now you're just staring at me.
Oh, so it gets like creepy almost. Like, she's doing it intentionally.
I think she's doing it sincerely.
Babe, you gotta blink at a certain point. Yeah. At a certain point, you gotta blink, babe. Like, you gotta
just say something.
Okay, I do like it when a girl like dressed in like a, I think like summer, like a summery dress where it's like light patterns or something. But like, anyways, they're showing off maybe the parts of their leg, like in sandals or whatnot. But I find that I think that's like a turn on for me. Like, kind of very comfortable with themselves.
So like a sundress, but not like a bodycon, you know?
Do
you know what I mean? Like tight, like a tight dress.
Body
like contour. That's what body con is.
Look. I think we can all agree. If you can pull off like a tight dress, then hey, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, in the same vein, Jen, do you like a fitted shirt on a guy? Do you like it when it shows a little bit of the pecs?
Okay, wait. It depends. I can see that going very wrong. Like, too thin, you know, and like too tight. Like a long sleeve, and you can tell like the build a little bit.
Yeah.
I feel like,
you leave a little to the imagination, but you can tell there's like...
Yeah.
But if you can like draw circles, then it's too much. Tight. Like, you see this curvature. Too, that's too much.
For me, it's definitely like the... They don't look like they're buff, but they are buff.
That's your thing. It's like, I don't want it to be explicitly out there. You know what I mean? I want it to be a little, but I'm just going to give him the benefit of the doubt that he looks good.
Exactly. You know?
When a girl or a person I'm interested in finishes the song, like just breaks out into the same song, I'm like, whoa, turn on.
Turn on.
Whoa, I am turned on.
It's like you're on the same page about music taste, I guess.
Yeah, but it's like, it's not only that you recognize it, but you're like, you vibe with it.
You know, along that page, it's like when guys play like old throwback Disney Channel music or something, like proudly in their car. I've had that experience before, and I'm like, I did not expect that from you, but this is great.
Is it a turn on though?
Yes, because it's like not being ashamed about like, oh, I like this music.
That's so me, because like I grew up in Atlanta, so I have a lot of rap influence, right? So I'll put on some like heavy trap, all this stuff, and then I can throw on Camp Rock right after. Like, this is me. This is me. Like, with Demi Lovato. Oh my gosh, inside and out. I know all the lyrics. You know what I mean?
You don't like this. This is real. This
That's
is
a good
me.
Test. Bring it into the car. You just start switching the genres up.
So it definitely seems like that surprise of like, oh, you know, or you like that surprise aspect, I think would be the turn on, right? Because it's like you didn't foresee this to happen. It's like, oh, okay.
But yeah, Jennifer's just giving us like how to get a girl 101 right
there. Yeah.
She's
there's a guy taking notes that's gonna roll up his sleeves and play music.
Jen's speaking now. Okay, I'll take notes.
When guys play with babies.
Oh, you have baby fever?
I do have baby fever. Oh, but man. I do not want to give birth anytime soon. But it's funny because like people always say like also say like guys playing with puppies. I feel like that does nothing for me. Like, whatever. But, like, with babies specifically, it shows, like, how nurturing a guy can be or someone can be, and like how like, caring one. They are. Yeah, and like very, if they're very careful and like fun, you know, I feel like it shows a lot.
Similarly, on that note, it's like you want to see how that person treats people around them, because the way they treat you, especially if it's early on, can only last so long.
That's true.
It could be a facade. And so like if they're just a jerk to everyone, or if they're just like not genuine to people around them, the people close to them, that's like, that's something to note.
If they're like, go to like a restaurant and they like spark conversation with like a stranger or like with a waitress like really I would be like, wow, you're just a genuinely kind person.
That's attractive. That's very
like you're not shy from to have those like interactions. I like that.
This episode is brought to you by BetterHelp. BetterHelp is an online platform making professional counseling accessible, affordable, and convenient anytime, anywhere. BetterHelp will assess your needs and match you with a licensed professional therapist. I think it's great because I can reach out to my counselor anywhere in the world and start communicating in under 48 hours. It's not a crisis line. It's not self-help. It's professional counseling done securely online. After logging on, you'll get timely and thoughtful responses. Plus, you can also schedule weekly video or phone sessions from the comfort of your home. It's more affordable than traditional in-person counseling, and financial aid is available. BetterHelp wants you to start living a happier life today. You can get 10% off your first month by going to betterhelp.com/lunch. That's betterhelp.com/lunch for 10% off your first month. Join the 1 million people who have taken charge of their mental health with a licensed professional. Now let's get back to the episode.
Is there anything you guys think are turn-ons that you guys do? I'm pretty curious about that too.
I don't think I lean into that stuff.
I like that question. There are definitely some things I do. Like I'm trying to be more confident, or like, you know what's sexy? Good posture. Oof, that's sexy.
Ooh, I was gonna say that too.
Good posture, sexy.
Everyone suddenly sits up straight.
Like they're when they're walking.
You can tell when someone's not as confident. It's true.
I actually used to do the, I would like be very conscious of my posture when I'm in public, but now that I'm like in a relationship, I just got lazy, so my posture is just...
No!
You've changed, Chris.
It's compromised.
Your back posture's changed. Yeah. Back to the question of...
Yeah.
What turn-ons do you think you have?
Oh, I'm curious. I think it'd be funny.
I know like things I used to think, like when I was in middle school...
Oh,
if there was a soccer ball, I would try to juggle. Because I was very proud of me being able to juggle, like, maybe 5 times. You know, like, one.
Wait, juggle?
Just when they were looking.
No. Like, juggle? When you juggle a soccer ball, it's with your feet. Oh. Like, with the feet.
Yeah, not this. Not this.
That
would be a little weird.
Wait, you used to play soccer, right?
Yeah, and this is like PE specifically, and not everyone would like play soccer.
So you're kind of like show off your little like
a little
like
show off
kind of thing. Yeah, okay.
Or maybe this is like middle school or junior high. Like whenever we're like playing sports, and then there were some like cute girls in like the PE class. Like you would just like go above and beyond, and like be like you would stay the longest in like dodgeball.
If you could That's do a so pull true. Up in PE, I'd be like, girls are totally interested in that.
Men so get so competitive. It's so funny.
That's so funny because like, I don't remember those things. Like that's not something like I looked out for. Like he was the last one in dodgeball.
I'm hosting this new series for Jubilee. It's like a dating.
Oh yeah.
We're starting this new series. It's like a game show, but basically it's like Bachelorette. So like, one guy or one girl and a bunch of other guys and girls, right? But for the girl episode. On this topic, we have to showcase a talent, right? And then the guys were like, I challenged the other guys to a push-up contest, and the guys
are just like doing
push-ups.
Serious?
Like, how many push-ups can I do in like 30 seconds? You know? And I was like, that's funny.
That's so funny. That's not really attractive to me. Like, that's just showing how bro you guys are.
Yeah, that's more for the guys than it is for the girls.
Like, I've been to someone's place before, like, you know, just like a birthday thing. And then, like, all of a sudden, the guys just start working out. And I'm like, why? And they just start, like, bench pressing. I'm like, alrighty. Like, you just, like, it's like, let them do their thing.
But But if they rolled up their sleeves.
So rolling up the sleeve, turns on, push up, then turn off.
Too much.
It's this weird dichotomy right there, yeah. There is one thing where I don't necessarily always tell people, like if it's a girl I'm talking to or if it's like very new, I don't showcase much on social media either, but I play guitar. I grew up playing guitar.
Oh yeah.
So that's like a very light, subtle flex that I sometimes do.
That's one of my weaknesses, like dancing and guitar playing.
I love both. I love dancing. I mean, you guys know, I mean, anyone that follows me knows I love dancing. And so another thing with dancing, I don't showcase it much on social media, but like when I'm out in public, or if it's at a club, if it's at a function or whatever, right? That's where a lot of my confidence is. It's just like the way I can express myself with dancing and just like having fun. Because my approach with dancing is not like amazing. It's like choreography. I'm not like amazing, but I'm like, I'm just good enough where I can sprinkle it with humor and then like blending like fun skill. It's a great combination.
So you see, I think the theme is like not trying too much, you know.
There's
a balance.
So Jen, guitar playing, like, was there like a specific song that you liked? Jason Mraz
style. Like, what kind of guitar?
Not electric.
Classic. I mean, not classic. Yeah, classic or like acoustic.
Like finger style.
Yeah, just like like very chill. Like, it's like you're chilling out. You just hear it in the background. Like, it's just very calm. It's kind of like the lo-fi feel, you know? Like you're just like chilling out together. Like, to me, it's like there's something like, I don't know, it feels like a bonding moment there.
Jen, we never asked you though, what do you think you have
that is, gosh, wait, you're like, you mean like that I do? I feel like you don't do anything on purpose. If anything, I like wearing short shorts and like short skirts.
Is that it?
Are you confident in your legs?
I like my legs, yes. Okay, I like showing off my legs.
Nice, okay.
If anything, it's that. Confident. Yeah.
Let's transition to some qualities.
So one I have is when someone is very well spoken yet charismatic at the same time. So like they sound very intelligent when they're talking, and I'm like, this guy knows his stuff.
This guy took speech in college.
I have someone specifically in mind when I think of this.
Say it right now.
No, it's, you don't know. He's from college. But he was like someone within our organization. All the girls had a crush on him, and it's just like, it's funny because like, you think like the girls, I don't remember. I don't know.
So you can command the room.
I don't know.
We'll have a guest for us right here.
Like, I don't, like, you know, stereotypical, you think that girls are attracted to the jock or, you know, the popular guy, whatever that means. But this guy is like, he's like everything, all of that, you know, like, he's able to command the room and everyone just listens. Wow. Just, that was very attractive. That was very attractive.
Damn, that's hot. Yeah. I want to backtrack to what you just said, Jennifer, but. Charisma sexy. Charisma just in general. If someone just has like,
same.
If you have like that little spunk or something about you that's uniquely to you and you own it, because everyone's a little weird, right?
Yeah.
But
of course.
But just kind of like, I don't know, embracing that and just like that, like, yeah, this is me, and like that's attractive.
Yeah. And some level, that's what confidence is too, or what people refer to when they say broadly confidence. It's like, okay, but like, oh, it's like owning it, owning your little quirk.
She can be the hottest girl ever, but, and this doesn't even have to be relationship wise. It can just be like just human interaction, but like banter. Oh my God.
Yes.
That's everything.
Something. Banter, I think we all can agree. Everything.
Yeah.
It's like sharp too, but they're quick about it, you know?
Yeah, like wit.
Witty.
Okay, so wit is hard to, it's a tall demand. So I don't always, it's not like a expectation, but I allow myself to be surprised if she is witty.
Can keep
like,
up.
Witty can be pretty tough. That's probably one of my strong points. I consider myself very like quick and witty. But if I can find someone that's kind of like matches that and like kind of like banters back, I'm like, yo, like, when is this happening? Yeah. Like, yo, we need to go. Like, exactly. Look.
You're always leaving.
I'm always leaving.
To go to another thing.
I'm a personal guy, okay? I like to keep a lot of, like, my private, like, personal life private.
You know, all these things, I feel like it just shows, like, it's like you have, like, high level, like, brain, like, connections.
Yeah. There's a mean version of this person.
Like, wittiness is like you're able to recall something that relates to a situation, you know, and it's like, bam.
Yeah, Yeah.
It's also adaptability. It's a lot of these things too. You're like very comfortable with yourself and like you have like a charisma.
Along with the brain, for me, emotional intelligence.
Oh, yes.
Very EQ. Up there.
But a lot of men don't have that.
I am starting to realize
men
that.
Men suck. Men really suck.
Men are terrible with
really bad with EQ. Quotient.
Thank you guys for realizing
that. For sure. I've met so many guys that have terrible EQ.
I would say you guys have pretty high EQ. It's just sometimes like, you know, like things like I don't know. It's just being vulnerable and like being empathetic. Like those, you know, it sounds like simple things, but apparently it's not. So like when someone can be very empathetic and like very like, it's just like there for you. It's like, wow, that's great.
Even like what we're talking about fakeness, all these qualities, like someone could be like trying to implement these like very inauthentically and disingenuously. It's like, I'm going to roll up my sleeves. I'm going to start putting Disney music on. It's like, no. Baseline, be genuine, be authentic. And these are things that people typically like, right?
Like if it doesn't apply to you, so be it. So what?
And owning that that's sexy, like knowing that, you know, that thing is like, that's not me, and that's okay.
Yeah, very true.
It's true.
It's almost like we already started wrapping out. That like this was already a great way to.
We just came. We came full circle, y'all.
Yes.
Well, we talked a lot about our turn-ons in this episode. I think we can go on for a long time. But let us know if there's any that you have or that you like, and leave in the comment below. We'd love to read it. Thanks again, June, for being a guest on Lunch Break. It was so fun to have you. Anything you want to plug? Anything coming out?
Yeah, hopefully. I am starting a new project, like I said, with Jubilee. I'm hosting my own little show series. So hopefully that picks up, and it all depends on your viewership and comments and shares to keep this an ongoing project. So I'm very excited about that. I host my dating show on Twitch every Saturday, but yeah, just check me out on socials.
For sure, yeah. Really excited for those that show. We'll keep an eye out for it. Go support June. We'll put some links down below for you to follow. Big thanks to our plus one, Andrew Chan, for joining us today. If you want to be a care holder, you can find us on Patreon.
We also have new merch, the core collection at wongfustory.com, so go check it out. We also have a podcast on all the streaming platforms, and lunch breaks are every Thursday.
All right. See you guys next time.
All righty. Bye, guys.
Bye.